Hey guys, it's Hannah and this is Bookworms Talk, and today I'm going to film a Halloween tutorial on this look right here, Little Red Riding Hood, R-E-D and R-A-A-D, because what you can do for a cute little twist is fill a little basket with a couple of your favorite lightweight books and carry it with you, because not everyone goes trick-or-treating, and this would be a cute little thing to add to just the typical Red Riding Hood outfit. So if you want to see how I got this look, then keep on watching. I've already moisturized and primed my face and then put on my standard foundation. And now I'm going to go in with a little bit of bronzer and blush. But first, I think we're gonna zoom into this. Now I'm going with my Sonia Kashuk blush in Pink Rose. Now I'm just blending it all out. Now I'm going to do the brows, and I'm using my Anastasia Beverly Hills brow pencil in, I think this is blonde or taupe. This is dope. No, I can't deal with it. I must tweeze. Sometimes when you're blonder, you can get away with it for longer, but it just couldn't last. So I just did a little bit of trimming, not really much, but I had to do something. She's curled up in the basket. Oh my gosh, all of you are adorable. So now I'm just going to run through with my Milani Brow Fix, and I'm gonna use the middle shade. This is in Light. Now I'm going to prime my lids with the Behind the Scenes Lorac Eye Primer. Now I'm just going to take this middle shade right here from my Milani Brow Fix palette, and I'm going to take that on a shader brush. Now before I forget, I'm going to curl my lashes. And now even though I have gone in with the crease shade, I'm going to go in with the NYX Jumbo Pencil in Milk. And I'm just going to focus this right on my eyelid and blend it out with my finger. And I'm going to go in again with the darkest shade. This is a dark matte brown from my Milani Brow Fix. You could use Espresso from the Lorac palette. You can just any dark matte brown color. And I'm going to really focus that just on that little outer V, and then I'm going to kind of work that right around my lash line. Now I'm just going in again with the darker color on the shader brush. I want to add a little bit of the Urban Decay Rockstar, which is just this deep purple color with a little bit of shimmer in it. And I'm going to take that on this brush, which I've cleaned off, and I'm going to very, very lightly work this into the little outer V right there. Because I have hooded eyes, I have to go up more with this because it just disappears, like you see. So I have to go kind of above here. And I typically just, I think of butterfly wings, and that helps me really, I don't know, it's all a mental thing, but if you don't have quite so hooded eyes, you could pretty much just focus this just on the lid and be fine. And again, just going back with this, and I'm going to run the dark brown from the Milani palette right under my lash line. Now that I have kind of the less precise line right there, I'm going to go in with just a small liner brush and really focus it in on the outer part. Just again with that dark brown. And now I'm just taking a shader brush and kind of blending out the edges. And now just with a little spongy brush that comes with the Milani palette, I'm going to go in with the light highlighter shade, and I'm going to hit right here. And then again with the middle shade, I'm going in and blending with my shader brush. This is just a lot of blending, and that's important, especially with darker purples and just dark colors in general. You have to do this a lot. Now this is the time where if you are able to do winged eyeliner, I am not part of that rare species of people, then go ahead and do a winged eyeliner now, but it's not in my capability. So I'm going to go in with Espresso from the Lorac palette just because it's a little more pigmented, and I'm going to dampen this brush and work it right along there. And I'm actually not going to I'm actually not going to create a wing on this. I'm just going to kind of line my eye. Then I'm going to repeat this step down here because I want it a little bit darker. Now I'm going in with the crease brush and I'm blending a little bit more just because I'm not quite happy with it. Now I'm going to go back with the NYX Jumbo Eye Pencil in Milk and I'm going to line the inner part of my waterline. Now I'm going to put on some false lashes. These are some Ardell ones that I had cut up because I don't like the full lash look on me personally, so I'm just going to add them to this outer V. And I'm just using the Duo Lash Adhesive and I'm putting that on the back of my hand. Now I just wait for it to get tacky. Now you can always do this with tweezers. I'm going to attempt to, but I might end up ditching them just because I'm not used to it. This is a step that I probably should have done before I put my lashes on, but we're gonna try to do it now after this dries for a minute, and I'm going to hit my top waterline with the Master Drama by Maybelline in Midnight Master. That wasn't too bad. If you forget, it's not the end of the world. Now I'm going to go in with my Voluminous Butterfly Mascara in, I think this is by L'Oreal. Yes, this is by L'Oreal. And then with another brush by the Butterfly line, and I'm just going to do my lashes and whatnot. And now I'm going to go in with the Stila Single Eyeshadow in Kitten, and I'm going to hit that on my brow bones, a little bit on my inner corner again, and my cheekbones. Going through the lips because it isn't Little Red Riding Hood without a red lip. So I'm going to use the NYX Lip Liner in red. I'm going to use the Revlon Color Burst Matte Balm in 520 Standout. Wow, I can't read. It just as this, but I want to really, really have that matte finish. So I'm going to go in with the Hourglass Liquid Lipstick in Icon. This is kind of an expensive lipstick, so I mean, any drugstore one is really fine. I know the NYX lipstick in, in Chaos is a pretty good dupe to it. It doesn't have quite the same finish, but the color is right on. And then the last step. Then just finish it off with a red coat that you can get literally anywhere. I got this at Kroger. And then pair it off with a white dress, like a very simple kind of thing. And you can't forget your basket of goodies. And I'm not forgetting that this is a book channel, so maybe fill it with a couple of your favorite thin, lightweight books. So I thought this was a cute little twist on little red, as in R-E-A-D, Riding Hood. And just carry around a little basket of books. So I hope you guys enjoyed this, and stay tuned for my next tutorial that I will be doing at the end of the month. I think I can do one more, and I think it's gonna be a little creepier. Maybe not for most people, but for me, quite terrifying. If you know my channel, I think you might know what it is I'm thinking of. So I'll see you guys later next time on Bookworms Talk. Bye. So now I'm just going to run through with my Balani. Oh, hey, knock it off. You're relentless. Say, I'm guilty of eating the box. Stop doing it. Stop. 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 Stop it. It's not good.